So we can talk about the robots, we can share videos, but the best way to interact with our robots is to just see them and interact with them. So let's meet Spot, have Spot come up on stage. So Spot's being driven by our own robot wrangler. This is Rob Collier. He's our senior manager of infrastructure and cybersecurity on our team at Boston Dynamics. Very occasionally, we get to take the robots out in the field, which is a huge thrill for us. We will be walking around after the program today in the cocktail lounge, so please come over and say hi. Feel free to take the robot for a spin, take a selfie. Spot loves to take pictures. Rob is driving the robot today. It's easier for us to do it in a demo situation. Normally, like I said, at our customer sites, they will be given an autonomous mission, and it will just be programmed to do movement on its own. You can see there are a number of different types of gates. Some of it's used for a particular purpose. If it had a surface that was particularly slippery or rough or uneven, we could do something like an amble where you'd have 3 points of contact. Some of these other movements around jogging, moving, more really for fun to show off a little bit about the robot. The robot itself weighs about 65 pounds. There's 5 cameras in the robot, 2 in the front to give you about 180 degree view. So Rob can see on his console, he can see what Spot sees. There's 2 cameras on the side, 1 camera in the back. So Spot gets a full 360 degree view. All right, so Spot is constantly making a terrain map of all around it so they can see any type of obstacle. You can see it moves with relative ease forward, backwards, side to side, right? We've brought also along with Spot an arm. It looks like a head, it's an arm. It's trying to step on my toes, sorry. Won't do it. It'll detect an object. The arm can be used for gripping and maneuvering. It can be used also for observation. There's actually a camera in sort of the mouth or the palm, depending on how you want to do it. And I wanted to know if Spot wanted to pick something up. Did Spot want to play some fetch? Yeah? Yeah? We could do it. Take it. If only we had some dice here in Las Vegas. All right. So what's going to happen here is that Rob is going to give it an instruction to pick something up. He's not going to move necessarily to the object. We can give it an instruction. The robot will walk over to the object and reach down and pick it up. You can tell it, how do you want to pick it up? Do you want to scoop it? Do you want to go top down? And so he's not driving. He's just allowing it to pick it up. Okay, once you can see that there was a correct grab, it will pick it up, and it can move. Now, one of the other things that differentiates these types of autonomous robots is that while it has 4 legs and it can move around, that arm is doing something completely independently as well. All right, if Spot is so inclined, we bring it back to me. All right, very good. Thank you, Spot. All right, we're going to let Spot take a bow here. Oh, we got a dance? We got a dance? All right, might have another dance here. So we have a software developer who a bunch of us have come to know. Her job is choreographer. She was a dancer in college, and now she writes code that goes into the software development kits that you can download with the robots. And so she'll choreograph many of the different dances that you might see on YouTube and social media with the robot. I think that might actually be the coolest job in the world, but that's okay too. Yeah, we're good. Good. I'm going to take a bow. Good job, Spot. All right.